Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is your math class for grade 4 from Pakistan International Taif. And today we are going to start page number 64. Open page number 64. On page 64, you have question number 4. In question number 4, the question is, in each set of equivalent fractions, circle the fraction that is in its lowest terms. Okay, the fractions are given here. This one is A. In A, 2 over 5. 4 over 10, 8 over 10, 6 over 15. Dear student, this is a question and we have to find which one is in its lowest term. First of all, you have to know that a fraction where the numerator and denominator cannot be reduced any further is said to be a fraction in lowest term. So here you see that this is 2 and this is 5. We cannot reduce this one. This is 4, this is 10. We can divide or reduce into another number. This is 8 and this is 10. It can be reduced. This is 6 and this is 15. This also be reduced. So our answer is this one, because it cannot reduce further. And you have to circle this one. This is in lowest term. Okay? B. In B, you have 6 over 14, 12 over 28, 3 over 7, and 9 over 21. So here you have to check which can. This is 6, this is 14, it can be divided by table of 2. This is 12, this is 28, it can be reduced by table of 2. This is 3 and this is 7, it cannot be reduced. So this is the answer. You have to circle this one. This can be table of 3. 3 3s are 9, 3 7s are 21. So this one is your answer. C. 9 over 30. 3 over 10. 12 over 40. And 21 over 70. So here you see that which one is cannot be reduced another from. This is 9, this is 30. It can be reduced by the table of 3. This is 3, this is 10. So it cannot be reduced. So this is our answer. It's in lowest term. Here 12, this is 14, it can be divided by table of 4 or 2. This is 21, this is 70, it can be divided by table of 7. So this one is your answer. Okay, dear students, you have to circle these answers on your book. Okay. Next, question number 5 is, reduce these fractions to their lowest terms. Question 5, part A, 18 over 24. 18 over 24. Now we have to reduce into their lowest term. this is 18 and this is 24. You can see that the table of 2, 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. 24 divided by 2 is equal to 12. Here you can see this is 9, this is 12. It can be divided by the other number, divided by 3. 9 divided by 3 will be 3. 12 divided by 3 will be 4. So this is lowest term. Next one B is 15 over 25. 15 over 25. You can see that this is 15 and this is 25. We can divide by 5. 15 divided by 5 will be 3. 25 divided by 5 will be 5. We cannot divide further. This is 3 and this is 5. This is in lowest term. C. C is 10 over 12. 10 over 12. 10 and 12 can be divided by 2. 10 divided by 2 will be 5. 12 divided by 2 will be 6. And it cannot be divided by another number. And this is your answer. And this is in lowest term. I need 3 part A, B, C, D, E, and F. You will do by yourself in your notebook. And this will be your homework, okay? Now, you have question number 6. Write the HCF of these pairs of numbers. Dear students, you already done these HCF. So, HCF means highest common factor. Question number 6. Part A, HCF of 20 and 16. 20 and 16. First of all, we will find the factors of 20 and 16. Factors of 20 is equal to, we have to use rough work 20, you have to divide by prime number, 2 1s are 2, 0 will be here, 2 5s are 10, 5 1s are 5. So we have applied the factors of 20, 2 multiply 2 multiply 5 multiply 1. Now you have tried factors of 16. This 2 here, this 2 will be here, and this 1. These are common factors. Now we have to find HCF. HCF means highest common factor. You have to multiply. 2 multiply 2 multiply 1 is equal to 2 2's are 4. 4 1's are 4. This is one step. Highest common factor is 4. Same, you have question number 6 part B, 17 and 7. 17, this is N part B. So you have to add factors of 17 and then factors of 7. Factors of 17 is equal to, here we will check. Seventeen is a prime number, so you will say 17 ones are 17. So here 17 multiply 1, and then we have five factors of 7. Factors of 7. You also make a factor of 7. This also prime number, so 7 ones are 7. 7 multiplied by 1. Now we have to write common factors. Common factor. This one is common factor. And this also is highest. Common factor is 1. This one. 1 is highest common factor. Okay, dear students. I did 2 parts A and B. C and D you will be doing yourself. Okay. Now you have question number 7. Question 7 is also same as question 5. Reduce these fractions to their lowest terms. So A, 12 over 20. So we have to reduce this into their lowest term. So you see that this 12, this 20 can be divided by 2. 12 divided by 2 will be 6. 20 divided by 2 will be 10. Again we can see that this can be divided by the table of 2. So 6 divided by 2 will be 3. 10 divided by 2 will be 5. And this is in lowest term. B is 10 by 100. 10 over 100. So you can divide by 2. 10 divided by 2 will be 5. 100 divided by 2 will be 50. Okay, and then this is 5 and this is 50. It can be divided by 5. 5 divided by 5 will be 1, and 50 divided by 5 will be 10. And this is your lowest term. C. In C, you have 30 divided by 31. 30 divided by 31. Here you can see that this is 30 and this is 31. 30 can be divided by table of 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15. But this 31 is a prime number. Prime number is that number which cannot be divided by other than itself or 1. So we cannot divide 31 by other number. So this is lowest term. So you will leave it as it is. Okay? question number 8. I did 3 parts, A, B, C, and you have D, E, F is your homework. Next question number 8.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.